Just before saying a few words about the film, I want to refer to the title, to the main theme of the conference, Us, Crisis, and Working Through. Now, about the film, Us, maybe, Crisis, certainly, indeed a rather dramatic one, though, of course, it's also a chronic one, if we can combine the word crisis with the word chronic. And working through, it seems to me, no way, no working through in this. And also, something else I wanted to say about the past. I was not long ago at the Freud Museum in London, and there was, as often do, have art exhibitions there. And there was an exhibition of cartoons by someone called Carlin, who was a well-known cartoonist, who was making cartoons every day for the Times. And Kalman had also been in St. Francis and sent some of his cartoons around art analysis. And there was one about a patient who was reflecting Ben and Little Man in this cartoon. And he was saying, I've been talking about the termination of my analysis with the analysis for the last 10 years. So that is not a good example of that. Anyway, let's come to the film. And the first comment I must make is about Radu describing it as a comedy, and I have a problem with that. Of course, there are many funny comedy bits in it, many statements and sentences and jokes and so on, and I've heard people behind me laughing at them. But I would think twice before I'm calling it a comedy. And of course, something we can discuss together with Radu himself and with you. Fuck off. These are the first two words that Marius utters after getting up from his messy bed in his messy flat as he tries unsuccessfully to get through to his ex-wife. These words are followed soon after by a "you fucking cunt" and not much later by a "fuck off" or a "break your neck," said with some background to a kid washing his car window in a traffic jam. A man in the market where Marius goes to buy a paper to wrap up his present for his daughter Sophia offends his own wife using similarly vulgar words, almost to confirm, to generalize, normalize that this is what men are like, and that we should just accept it as a fact of life. Now, in spite of such foul and aggressive language, however, Marius appears as an altogether likable, if somewhat high-strung character. And as we get to know him better, we will also discover some other aspects of his personality, such as his sarcastic sense of humor, and his narcissistic self-delusional conviction of being always the best and always right. Remember when he comments on the danger of his mother-in-law, he said, well, the danger is right because I did it, as if that was automatic. He couldn't even consider hearing that something like himself. But also, he's not ungenerous. He may have verbally threatened the boy who had washed his windscreen, but then he had given him some money. And later he buys a plant of orange Usmania from his mother-in-law Coral and offers her a free dental consultation. After a bike ride through the Bucharest traffic to visit his parents and borrow their car for the weekend, we watch Marius being provoked by his father into an unpleasant argument. The father, only on the surface an affectionate and jolly man, calls him a coward for not standing up to his ex-wife, Ottilia. Marius retaliates by calling him a monster and leaves his parents for a sulk without taking the car keys he had on the neglect. We reluctantly accept them, though, when they are pushed into his hands by his long-suffering mother, who had adopted throughout the argument conciliatory stance, trying to make peace between her two men. Something you can guess she must have done so many times before. We have been offered here sort of a preview of what will happen later in the film. Indeed, we may speculate that the tension in Marius' family of origin must have provided a blueprint for, if not also have been part of the cause of, his failed marriage